river.
Good afternoon, Trinity Christian. Welcome to Trinity Christian Sports here on YouTube and to Midland for game one. Two games set this week, Trinity Christian versus the Midland Classical Knights. We'll get started here in a few moments with the lineups and first pitch.
Yes, it's awesome.
Got a ball, man. It's definitely right. I'm ball, but it's kind of build it as you go, I guess. 90 folks online, glad to have you with us here on YouTube, Trinity Christian Sports. Ford here, sitting next to Coach Hiley, who's running Game Changer. We'll be getting some stats off of him, and I'm sure we'll get some awesome snarky comments from Hiley as we go along during this live stream. Your lineup for Trinity Christian today is batting first, J.J. Martinez, and playing third base. I'll get back to that in a minute. I'll start that over as they're starting the announcements.
Time we will introduce the players for both teams, followed by a word of prayer and the Star Spangled Banner. First up, the starters for our visitors from Lubbock. Leading off, playing third base, number 3, J.J. Martinez. Batting second, playing catcher, number 10, Hunter Bolinar. Batting third, playing shortstop, Kyle Machigumba. Batting fourth, designated hitter, number 13, Colin McKinnon. Batting fifth, playing left field, number 7, Cooper Young. Batting sixth, playing second base, number 35, Noah Tapp. Batting seventh, pitching today, Andrew Kincaid. Batting 8, playing right field, number 22, Brand. And batting 9, playing center field, number 15, Carson Castillo. And playing first base, number 26, Caden Castillo. And the rest of the line.
Thank you.
So maybe you heard all that, folks. Batting first for Trinity, J.J. Martinez. Second, Hunter Molinar. Third, Kyle Muchagumba. Fourth, Colin McKinnon. Fifth, Cooper Young. Sixth, Noah Hassey. Seventh, Andrew Kincaid. Eighth, Brant Slicker. And ninth, Carson Castillo. We'll go over the positions in between innings and as the lines take the field for the bottom of the first. First pitch coming up. Christian 5-1 in district, and Midland Classic, I believe 2-0 after, what, two wins over Willow Park, is that right? They were both close wins, if I remember right. Trinity Christian demolishing Willow Park, the first opponent of district. First pitch ball. Don't think I'm going to say every pitch, though. Ella probably used to me doing that at home. Indeed. Place it, JJ. Ball. Again, this is game one. Game two will be on Saturday from Lions Park. The game originally scheduled to be on Friday. So we moved to Saturday so we can celebrate Good Friday. Base hit, JJ Martinez. Leadoff man on for Hunter Molinar. I don't know if you can tell on this field. Right field straight down the line is much closer than all the rest of the outfield fence. You can see the green scoreboard in right center. At that point, the field juts out towards the school in the distance, a good 20, 30 feet. So all those signs you see on the right of the green sign, much closer than all the rest of the field. Ball one. That's true, indeed. Hunter and Brant are, I'm sure, salivating over that fence in the right field. I think he was trying to hit it there, but not really his pitch. I'm surprised he swung at that. You do have some ominous clouds moving over us from, I don't even know what direction that is over there. That should be west, yes? West? Gotcha. It's the other way. Clouds are moving in from left field to right field, and they're bringing what looks like moisture. Hunter hits it to second base, flipped to second. One does not get the second. Fielder's choice. JJ's out at second for Kyle Muchagumba. Swing by about a of swing. Sorry. That's what you get here on Trinity Christian Sports. Nothing but professionalism.
Fouled off.
Should be At first, you got Caden Castillo, who's being DH'd for. At second, you got Noah Hassey. At third, you got J.J. Martinez. At short, you got Kyle Machigumba. In left field, Cooper Young. In center field, you've got Carson Castillo. And in right field, you've got Brance Lecker. Subs tonight for Trinity Christian, Maddox Metcalf, Rhett Hiley, who had a great game right before this one on the JV defeating Haskell's JV 6-3. Colt Condren and Kaysen Jones round out the subs for Trinity Christian in this game here in Midland. And we hope we get to play the whole thing. It looks decent in your screen right there.
Mm-hmm. Definitely looks like they're trying to be the second move here.
Yep.
road leader must have been something on the tag that the car saw there.
I think he learned his lesson on the last one. Fingers on the mound, so all that trying to keep him from going to second, and he gives him a freebie. There goes the traditional double play. That's out of play. Let's see if we get a windshield on this one. Two.
Yeah,
disappointed in himself, actually.
You can read his mind from here.
You can see how big he's at. He is.
Yep. Matt, he called that ball.
He's actually disappointed in himself right
yep.
here.
Yep.
Don't be shocked if we get a larger shotgun on this pitch.
So he steps off to lick his fingers. Now he's good. Boom! Called it. Eggs on the board. How many hits you got for each? We don't have. We don't have that box. The box score on one of those.
One and two. Two for us. One for Midland Classic.
Okay. Trinity Christian with two hits and Midland Classic with one. Brings up Noah Hassey, second baseman. So the 6, 7, and 8 hitters coming up for Trinity here in the top of the second. Sorry, I'm cold. Noah Hassey hustling down to second, and he drops the ball, so Noah is safe. He would have been out by about two steps had the second baseman come up with that. Do a job in here above. Oh, Oh, really? Going at the scoreboard, huh? I'm a lumberjack, and I'm okay.
He's going to double this thing in the gap.
That was
the setup for you guys.
Oh, we're going to call that a base hit, hopefully. See how Coach Halley decides to call that.
I'm calling that a hit.
Coach Halley's calling that a hit. Hit number 3.
See how I faked out because I know some high school coaches have a live stream going on in the dugout. So, clearly saw the butt sign there.
Sure he is. Yeah, these guys are watching YouTube in the dugout. First and third situation, nobody out. Lecker had a monster run 2 weeks ago, right over the right field wall, and he's got a right field wall that is very much in his favor today. He's getting old and he likes it. What, down and in? Is that what you said the other day? Pitcher dropped the relay from catcher to pitcher there home plate. On strike first, 1-0 with nobody out. I assume he's saying that the runner knocked the ball as he's sliding in. That's what he's probably doing. Get across.
Is it on the ball?
Yep. Strikes out. Foul tip out. One out, man on third for Carson Castillo. Another first pass.
Yes.
Plays a pretty good center.
Great center.
Good range.
Solid pitcher. Just high baseball IQ. Great young talent.
High, there's a high ball. Yeah.
Not one that you'll see chase out and punch down pitches.
Good. Wow, line drive, not able to be handled by the shortstop. Goes off his glove into short left. Another run coming in for the Lions. 2-0, one out here in the top of the second. Top of the order for the Lions and JJ Martinez. What did he do last time? Oh, don't worry about it. You don't have to do that.
He had a base hit to right center.
Okay, 1-for-1 base hit to right center. JJ hammers another one.
This time.
Carson booking it to third. Lions keep it rolling. JJ with 2-for-2 now with that drive to left center. Still only one out here in the second for the Lions and threatening to add some more to the score. Brings up Hunter, who grounded out to second in his last at bat. And that'll be another run for Trinity. Wild pitch. JJ moved down to second. 3-0 Trinity. Come on, Wind. You're free to die down a little bit. Don't know that it's going to happen. Hunter thought about it and thought otherwise. 2-0, remember, right?
Do not want to throw Hunter an inside pitch right now. He is dead red.
Please throw an inside pitch. Oh, he just missed it. Live streams. Once again, thank you for joining us here at Trinity Christian Sports. If you're logged into your account and you haven't joined or subscribed to the Trinity Christian Sports channel, why not? Slackers.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? What are you thinking? Hit that subscribe button now. I'm trying to hit 900 by the end of the year. I think we're around 889 or 890 right now. I just need 10 more to hit that magic 900 number, and then we'll start going after that 1,000. Hopefully hit that by the end of next year. Notification bell if you want to know every time we go live here on Trinity Christian Sports. Here we go with the 2-1 pitch. Oh, I just missed it again. 2-2. I think the good Lord's trying to help him with a gust of wind to right here. You see an angel in the outfield? He's like asking Hunter to hit it to him. Over there on the right field porch. Now's the time to do it there, Hunter. And he hits it that direction, but it's a bouncer that goes in. Oh, and it goes past the right fielder. It's going all the way to the wall. Hunter going around second before the ball's even touched. He's going to steam into third, standing up. Triple as the Lions add another one to the board. 4-0. Still here with one out in the top of the second. Hunter with a stand-up triple. Grounder that was able to get by the right fielder and go all the way to the wall. Manager coming out to talk to the pitcher. Okay, that should bring up Mooch. Kyle Machigumbu lined out to the right fielder. All right, was that the one that...
Yeah.
Oh, that was
a hit to right center.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. It was green. Duh.
It's the one that the center fielder threw home.
Oh, and kept us from scoring. It kept JJ from scoring in the first inning. As you heard, Coach Hiley, Kyle lined a single to right center in his last at bat. The entire Knights infield having a powwow on the pitcher's mound. Seeing whose turn it is. Wow, the wind. Oh, I should like clear out the count down here. Fouled off. 0-1 on Mooch. A one pitch Strike. Hunter Molinar standing on third base. Mooch trying to bring in Hunter. Got a pitcher's count here, 0-2.
Infield is in.
Yep, trying to keep Hunter from scoring. Oh, Mooch. Ah! Kyle Mitchum strikes out. Brings up Colin McKinnon. What did Colin do last time? Flew out to short right center. Strike on the inside corner. Ooh, just dropped my iPad. That would have been really bad. Took one off his left forearm, I think. The umpire's gonna give him a second.
Oh, his earpiece popped out there.
Oh, his earpiece? Okay, that makes sense. Getting all his signals and stuff.
They're using the fancy.
One of these days, that's probably gonna be legal. You think one of these days?
Illegal?
No, legal.
It is legal.
It is legal? See, I didn't even keep up with the times.
This is the first year for high school baseball to be able to use
that. I did not know that. Learn something every day.
The earpiece from the pitching coach to the catcher. Have the technology, earpiece technology yet for all the fielders, but the center can have an earpiece in Texas high school baseball this year.
Wow. Okay, there's a foul off to the right. That's going to make it to the road, I think. No cars in danger in that particular foul. Selfishly, and I shouldn't say it, but I'd like to see how many cars we can hit today. If that wind... Oh. That ball is going to end up, he caught it down the right field line right outside your screen. Colin McKinnon fouls out deep down the right field line to the right fielder. So that's it for the top of the second inning. Trinity Christian gets four runs. Going to bottom to second. Back with you in a sec. By the way, if this wind is getting too crazy on your speakers and stuff, I'd just turn this all the way down. Not missing too much with the okay, you're missing highly, but you're not missing too much with me talking. My color man is a slightly offended by what I just said. Dirt coming too. Right there. Bottom of the second. Hopefully this weather holds off. It's gotten raunchy windy just now. leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the second. Walked him. Live streams for the craziness that is Midland.
Fantastic. It's crazy how fast the weather has turned.
No lie, it was super nice an hour ago.
It winds at like 5 miles per hour during the JV game.
Yeah.
There's a strike. Yes, he did, and we got him caught up between first and second.
And we messed it up.
Bobbled the ball.
Good thing is, I don't think we see rain coming this way, but now the wind is just being a pest. There's a strike. 0-2 here on the second batter here in the bottom of the second after Andy walked the leadoff hitter. O2 pitch. Skied up, that'll be out of play. Barely, maybe not. Nope, out of play. Almost killed one of the ladies in her own little chair out there. Somebody not protecting their wife down there. Somebody's gonna be in the doghouse.
I think he actually threw her in the way.
You gotta knock that car down. I mean, knock that
in the middle. Apparently, she spent down a little too much at the Lulu store this morning.
Making assumptions over here.
And she was gonna take a foul ball to the dome.
To the dome.
Great pitch.
There's another foul coming back a little bit our way. Gonna be loud. Not too loud.
The mom only grabbed one of the two children.
Some mom down there had two kids. She grabs one and runs.
Some pretty fascinating things here.
And we're not supposed to have favorite kids, you know.
Some sacrificial things going on here. Tall city.
That's kind of wrong. Still 0-2. Do it again. Another one, almost the same spot, just a little bit deeper.
Oh, yeah.
And he had a chance to be a hero and just...
Yeah.
At least he got up and tried to protect his wife, so we'll give him credit for that. Yep. Slightly, now that I've said that, it'll hit me hard.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, he missed catching that liner by like 2-3 inches. 2-1 out.
Just barely over Noah's glove.
What number batter is this?
This is the eight hole.
Eight hole.
Cam Gilbert, left fielder. Okay.
Well, we don't know Cam, but knowing he's in the eight hole is actually interesting.
He has a brother on the team, I believe.
Okay.
Or two Gilberts. Okay. I believe they hit 8 and 9 in the lineup.
Nice. Hey, that sun feels nice. Your screen probably brightened up a little bit. We're at 22 live streams, Holly. They heard you were doing color today, and you were cracking everybody up.
Let's go.
With your stand-up or your sit-down or your...
I'm feeling 22.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you just keep telling people that. What are we waiting on? Something over there on the left field line. The big gates had come open. They're just securing the gate down left field line.
Well, the coach that is going to fix it, that doesn't seem to be too big of a hurry.
And I say we have 22 live streams, and immediately we drop two.
Unbelievable.
One out for the eight-hole hitter. Decent bunt, too. Come on, JJ. Got him. Two outs on that sack bunt. Hopefully we can get the nine-hole hitter here. A little Metallica walk-up song here.
Logan Gilbert.
This is Logan. Okay, nice to meet you, Logan.
He's a right fielder.
Made a great catch there to end the top of the session.
Tall drink of water.
Yeah, he is. Any one of these gusts of winds and he could be gone. Yeah, that's a strike, because your strike zone is enormous there, dude.
Using the 2021 meta, by the way. Louisville Slugger, great bat.
Strike two.
Swung that bat in some BP sessions. It's very pleasant.
It's very pleasant. Gotcha. Well, Andy Kincaid, a chance to get out of this inning with no damage right here. 0-2 on the nine-hole hitter with two outs, two on. I'll take that right there. Got it. Good job. Andrew Kincaid gets out of the inning with, as I said, the top of the third. Who do we have coming
Cooper
up here,
Young, Miley? Coming up. Cooper Young.
Cooper Young. That would be the 5, 6, and 7 hole coming up in the top of the third. Back with you in a second after pay some bills. Mr. Cooper Young do last time there, boss?
Grounded out to the first baseman.
Grounded out to the first baseman did Cooper Young. I've lost my tape. Oh well, it's all right.
You know who I bet loved that defense that played in that inning?
Who would that be?
Big old Steve Muchagumba watching with us from OKC today. Couldn't make it in on a Tuesday, but he's in Oklahoma City.
Shame.
Watching the live stream, enjoying the beauties of Texas through the screen while he's in the
terrible world of Oklahoma.
Wishing he was in Midland. Wow, the wind actually died down. We got some sun. It warmed up a little bit. I'll take it. Cooper, kind of a weak swing there.
Got fooled a little bit.
Yep.
Expecting breaking ball.
Is this the calm before the craziness? Because the wind went down to almost nothing. Ball. Struck him out. First out of the inning. Brings up Noah Hassey, who did what last time?
He walked last time. Walked. On four straight pitches.
On four straight pitches. We'll do that again.
Again, young man that just knows how to get on base.
Sounds like you're the president of the fan club.
You know, I just know baseball. And
sounds good.
Respect some baseball IQ doing the little things.
Awesome. Takes first ball strike. Grounds one to the shortstop. Thrown out 6-3. Second out of the inning. Brings up pitcher Andrew Kincaid. What did Andrew do last time?
The lumberjack singles on a bunt to the catcher.
Ah, that was that one that went down the third base line, wasn't it?
Pretty much guarantee we're not going to see that right here.
Yeah, with nobody on, Andy will not be bunting. But taking strikes. Looks like the Knights pitcher may have settled down a little bit. Or is this a different cat?
I believe it's the same pitcher.
Okay. In the dirt. Ball.
Kid's really trying to stay away from him. He's so outside. Probably not a bad idea.
Well, he's kind of scary because he's huge.
Yep.
Hard grounder to second. Lines go down 1-2-3 here in the top of the third. Going to bottom of the third. Trinity up 4-0. I always debate playing this song at our place. I don't know.
Stop debating it and just don't.
And just don't? I haven't. Because it's like kind of weird, but also kind of funny. Defense staying the same here in the bottom of the third. Nobody has changed at all. Again, if you missed it at the beginning, Trinity Christian coming in this game at 5-1 in district, and the Midland Classical is only at 2-0, their second district foe of the year, and the Lions fourth. Is that right? Is the math right on that one? Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
You are correct. Don't ask me to do math again, please.
Yeah, you probably have a headache now.
Yeah, that hurt.
I have heard if it hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe. I'll stop there. Should be their leadoff batter, right?
That is correct. Top of the lineup.
Top of the lineup.
Caleb Weeks.
For the Knights. Baseman.
Base hit to left field last time up.
Lovely. Ball. Swing and a miss. Or did he tip that one? I don't know. That was Hunter's glove or not.
Looks like classical. The Knights are sending number 35 out to the bullpen to loosen up.
Oh, really? There's a foul back, but no cars in danger on that one. Just some grass. And is it going to make it to the road? Nope, it's not. The 7-year-old that was running after it stopped just 5 feet short of the small
Where
highway.
Are your parents?
Yep. Ball just a bit outside.
Might be the same mom that only grabbed one of the children earlier on the foul ball.
Yep. Again.
Might be a family trait.
Oh, we're sinners. We have our favorites. I'm just playing. Fouled back, stayed alive. Count remains 2-2. So professional yawning on live stream. Oh, there's a tag, but right at the center fielder, Carson Castillo. First out of the inning.
Just a can of corn right there.
Just a can of corn.
Just a can of corn. Easy play for Carson.
Easy peasy.
No problem.
Emily Carr, being a little smart aleck, I'm such a trooper. Thanks, Em. I suppose you guys are. Oh, there's a foul that might hit a vehicle. No, it goes over all of them and lands in the streets. Emily Carr
Ellison praying right there. as the ball was flying towards the black bus.
It was flying towards the Trinity Christian bus. And there is a grounder to shortstop. And it should be an E6, yes.
Yes.
A bit of funky bounce off that lip from the grass to the dirt.
Yeah, kind of in between hops. Mooch tried to come through the ball, yep. A little bit on his backhand. Really probably had time to center that one up, but just one of those weird in-betweeners. You got to make a decision. He'll make it up for sure.
Yep,
we'll get the two ball right here.
That'd be nice to get the two ball. And a swing and a miss.
We had a strikeout looking out of Levi Bailey last time up.
Good. We can duplicate that result. Oh, one pitch. Hammers it to left center, but looks like Carson has a beat on it. He does. Second out of the inning. Going to try to get it back in time to double this guy off, but just a tad short. That's a good toss by that little kid, man.
Great toss.
I mean, he's just not this towering specimen of anything. He's just this freshman.
Got a little more meat on him than his brother does.
Well, his brother's a little more stretched out,
you know.
Wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
What big number 23 do last time?
Well, that's a great question. He struck out looking as well.
Okay.
So we had a little string of strikeout lookings here in the middle of the lineup.
Yep. Fouled off. This is going to hit a car, folks, and it's going to be good. And it bounces over the entire first row of cars and rolls under the second row. I am so disappointed. Strike one.
The guy in the Jeep should have stuck his hand out and made
it. He could have caught it, yeah.
I'm really a little disappointed in the lack of plays made by the Midland fans.
As they just sit there and are passive observers.
There really hasn't been a lot of plays made. plenty of opportunities.
One guy did try hard and missed. Oh, one. Hunter Molinar.
Hosed him. Great throw.
Threw up. The runner at second, ending the third inning. Going to the top of the fourth, Trinity Christian up 4-0.
Great throw, great pass.
Oh, wow. Take it. Should have 8-9-1 coming to the plate here in the fourth. Ah, I gotta stand up. Ziana? Who's it? Who are your kid talking to? Oh.
43.
Just heard is how many pitches Andrew Kincaid has through three innings. Not much. I don't think they're overly worried about using him too much, and I don't think they have a game until Saturday. Everybody's off tomorrow. Monster track meet on Thursday. Everybody's off on Friday for Good Friday. And then these two same teams will meet up at home, Lions Park, on Saturday. That will be our next live stream, by the way, if anybody was wondering, or you can make it out to the park. What time is that game on Saturday there, Mr. Hiley? Mr. Coach Hiley?
JV actually plays after varsity, I believe.
Okay.
So game times are 2.
That is if the varsity didn't get done in 2 hours.
Correct. JV just immediately followed.
Yeah.
Should be a great day.
Yeah. If they have some good weather and it's cold, needs to go. It's funny, February was so warm and March so far has been kind of chilly. I'm just a big pansy, which is probably more like it. All right. What did Brandt do the first time, boss?
Foul tipped out.
There you go.
So he's due.
Yep. We're looking for that shot to right. That ain't it. Ball one. Just a bit outside.
Trying to keep Brant away, trying to keep Brant outside. Not a bad idea on their part, but
must have scattered him.
Brant is being disciplined up there.
Yep. Fouls one back and only misses my gear by about 3 feet.
Play that you could have made, probably, but
if I leaned over the fence.
Would have probably had to sacrifice a couple of.
Did a Bartman. I'm not holding any pizza right now, though, so.
Probably would have had to sacrifice multiple pieces of equipment. Wise decision made.
Yes. 3-1, yes?
3-1.
Here we go. Let's get a good pitch for Brant right here, folks. 3-1 pitch, leadoff hitter here in the fourth, Brant Lecker. Hammers it. It's coming back
also
kind of by the way again.
Play that can be made by no one.
By no one, yep. We missed this by a few feet again. 3-2. Wow, he's just going to foul every ball to almost got, what is that, Maddox
almost,
Metcalf?
Almost
yeah.
Domed Maddox Metcalf.
Almost domed Maddox Metcalf, yep.
He's safe.
Yep. And Brant strikes out. He's taking his eyes off the ball there at the end. He's like throwing his chin or something. It looks like.
Yeah, I got a little fooled on that breaking ball. It's a good pitch. Carson up to the bat.
Carson.
Up to the plate.
Ooh, thought about bunting and thought, again, what did he do last time?
Line drive over the shortstop.
Gotcha. Another one to short. He's going to have to hurry. I don't know that I agree with that call.
He was making that call before
the ball ever got there. Well, hey, some people have places to be in, you know, an hour, hour and a half. So, top of the order for the Lions, J.J. Martinez. Two outs here in the top of the fourth.
Carson definitely made that one interesting.
Yep. J.J. almost gets domed himself.
We now have a Midland classical fan without his shirt on over there.
I'm over here freezing, and there's a seven-year-old kid without a shirt on. That makes no sense. Strike outside corner.
Got a lot of team spirit. Toughing it out for the team.
He needs to have a big M on his chest then. JJ fouling one off. We might get a car on this one, folks. We might have a car. And we hit the top of a car. No breakage of any kind.
That was GMC Terrain, everyone. Silver GMC Terrain.
And took it like a champ. No windshield, no glass breakage. And there is a grounder to second. And JJ is out 4-3. That's it for the Lions in the top of the fourth.
Four, five, and six coming up.
Gotcha. Getting a windshield cracked, but I haven't gotten it yet. Good call there, Miss Kincaid. Emily Carr, she wrote in earlier, I believe the girls are on their way to Tahoka to play a game. You might be able to follow them on Game Changer if you are interested. One of these days I should clone myself and get every game.
Big win yesterday over the Roosevelt Eagles.
So they did win. Okay.
The varsity won yesterday. In a run rule fashion.
Nice. Because I looked out the press box during the track meet, and I must have been watching during the JV game, because it was like...
Another one of those games where varsity played first, JV played second.
That is rather strange.
Also confusing because the varsities, both teams were wearing white.
That is so confusing when teams do that. Back out for his fourth inning of work. I believe that's his 44th pitch. It's actually a nice number for about nine. He got 0-2.
Two strikes looking to start the at bat.
Come on, Andy. Fouled out. First out of the inning here in the bottom of the fourth. I feel good. That's a good walk-up song. And somebody unplugged the scoreboard. There's a lot of small R's on it. Oh, and they plugged it back in.
Where did that one miss?
I think that was a ball.
so was the Empire.
There's a strike. 1-1. Apparently, our scorekeeper on the scoreboard decided to just forego the whole recording of balls and strikes and outs. There's a hard grounder down third base line, picked up by JJ Martinez, and he is able to throw him out. Great catch by Caden Castillo, having to tag the runners. It brings him down the line towards home plate. Here, two outs. I'm cold.
Don't make us go backwards, man.
Yeah, no lie. And the scoreboard's messed up again. There's a lot of ones out there now. It's 11-11. Nice line drive to center, right to Carson Castillo, and Andy Kincaid is out of that inning after, what is that, five pitches maybe?
He is now at 49.
Five pitch inning, as you heard from Coach Hiley there for Andrew Kincaid.
We were hoping for four, but yeah, got a little wild.
Holy cow.
Ended up with a five pitch inning.
We go to the top of the fifth. Trinity up 4-0. All right, remember, Hiley, you have a call you can. It doesn't have to be a home run. You can just call what's going to happen. Or have you already used that? I forget.
I have not.
Oh, okay.
Well, I guess I did call Andrews when he bunted, and I was expecting him to hit a ball hard to right center. I don't know if that counts as my call or not, but I was clearly massively
we will make the rule as you have to say. Yeah, we will make the rule that you have to say I'm using my call.
Okay.
And you know what? I'm just going for the fun of it, going and call it right now for me.
You're going homer from Hunter.
Yeah, I don't think it's really Hunter homer. Really, I think I'm kind of predictable, as every call I've used this season has been for Hunter Mulliner. I did semi-call it when he hit the two-run home run in La Mesa. As he looks up here and gives us a thumbs up. There's not three out, there's zero.
Very similar to Babe Ruth calling his own shot.
Yeah.
Looking at Coach Ford and smiling and giving a thumbs up.
Even though I don't think Babe actually called his shot. I think he was telling the dugout at Detroit to shut their mouths as he looked at him.
Very well could have been. However, I was not there.
Are you sure? You do seem older than the hills.
Yeah.
You did say your dad was 103 or 110.
He was there.
He was there.
He was actually the first base coach at that time when Babe called that shot.
Yeah, when Babe called it, okay. He fist bumped him after that home run.
He actually is so old, he called Babe Baby. It was Baby Ruth at that time.
It was Baby Ruth, hence the candy bar. Top of the fifth, 4-0 Trinity for Hunter Molinar. This game's actually going by really fast. It's only been an hour and 26 minutes, and I did start the live stream a hair early. Not really in Hunter's wheelhouse. Ball one.
Tell the Midland Classical plan was to stay away from the lefties.
Mm-hmm. That may be their common thing since they have that short porch over there. Oh, little bow. Somebody else moving their car out of that first row.
We have a switch in the bullpen catcher.
Red Hiley heading that way. Another ball. They're not going to give Hunter a chance, are they? Do I still lose my call if they don't even give him a shot?
I'm going to say yes.
Oh, you're probably
right. I'm
going to
say yes, you do.
Did your wife just get Starbucks?
She definitely Uber-eated some Starbucks here.
Okay, and that is not a free plug for Starbucks,
no.
Which is just glorified sugar water.
I'm going to.
Yeah, indeed. There you go. That's a good reason. Hunter Molinar walking on four pitches. Brings up Mooch.
Mooch. I did not.
You had a semi-call last inning saying Kai would make up for that error a minute ago.
Yep, I'm calling first pitch and let Hunter take second.
Okay, okay.
That's
wildly specific. Hunter's going to go on and take second anyway without Mooch swinging through it.
He actually did swing.
Oh, did he? Run? Picking up signs over there from Coach Rocha?
I was not. I just was making a baseball call.
Okay.
Their coach actually baseball interference. It clearly wasn't a strike.
Staying on second base. The temperature has dropped a couple of degrees. Make sure this doesn't fall over. Okay. Not if he doesn't get a chance to hit it.
1-1. Scoreboard is incorrect.
Double play.
Great throw by the first baseman. Wow.
He threw a bullet right where he needed it to be. Go from having a... Ouch. Don't give it to Ford. It's all good. Ford's freezing. It's all good. Oh, tag! Colin! Right to the center fielder.
Well hit ball.
Leadoff walk turns into three quick outs. Going to the bottom of the fifth, still 4-0 Trinity. Yowza. They used up all the hot drinks they had. They had to only give out cold ones.
I don't like Starbucks, actually. I know that's not a popular...
Oh, I'm with you on that, actually.
I have one drink I like at Starbucks.
Which is?
It is a honey citrus green tea.
A honey citrus green tea.
Yes, it is excellent. Hot.
Okay.
It's excellent.
The green tea crap.
You should try the citrus honey.
Citrus
green tea.
Honey. That's probably pretty good for you, too. Coming right now.
I like Black Rifle a lot.
Did you say Black Rifle?
Yep. I like Seven. Rifle. I like Seven Brews a whole lot.
Deathwish. You got a whole thing of Deathwish. It's absolutely really tasty. I had some all grind and rain. And what I don't get it is they have a store here.
They have Black Rifles here.
But we don't have one in Lubbock.
Oh, no.
Makes no sense. I mean, you can buy it at Walmart and stuff, but they don't have a store. Steph says your drink's a medicine ball.
Yes, that's what it's called. They don't call it that anymore, but that's exactly what it is, the medicine ball. It's wonderful.
Yeah. I drink it if I don't feel good.
You should drink it anyway because it's the best thing there.
Okay.
Coach McDonald, who's actually out recovering from the flu today, mentions that Seven Brews has great hot chocolate. He is just a big kid. And so
I was going to say.
He's still getting hot chocolate, but you got to love it.
Extra marshmallows?
Was that a fat joke?
No. What? It
better not be.
Why would that be a fat joke? I love marshmallows.
Seven eight nine
for Andy Kincaid. Is only just thrown his 50th pitch of the day.
Called a ball.
Okay, we got to stay consistent with questionable calls.
Umpire's been decent.
Yeah, it hasn't been bad.
He's missed a couple, but, you know, that happens.
Come on, Mooch.
Really deep in the hole. He's trying to go. Hunter's there. Going to throw him out. Trying to take second base. Great play.
Great job. Hunter Molinar to... That was to Noah Hassey, wasn't it? Yes, it was.
Great hustle from your catcher. Love to see it.
No lie.
Backing up first base, and he's got an absolute rocket.
Yeah, he does.
So,
my boy Hunter showing off his skills.
Not going to be super successful trying to take extra bases on Hunter Molinar.
Ball. Sorry, we've gone a number of innings without a golf story. We'll still forego that. Here's a grounder to second, right to Noah Hassey. Second out of the inning, 4-3.
So, well, I'll give you a golf story.
Oh, no.
Since you asked for one.
I shouldn't have said anything.
Since we are here in Midland.
You played the putt-putt here?
I spent the first, really, 12 years of my life in this area and living in Odessa.
I'm sorry.
They used to have the Texas Open.
Yes.
At the Odessa Country Club.
Wow.
And I actually was a sign carrier one year.
Oh, really?
At the Texas Open when I was like 8.
Nice.
Could barely carry the sign.
What'd your sign say?
It had the players' names on it.
Oh, okay. Oh, and their scores?
Uh-huh.
Nice.
I don't think I carried it for very long.
It was too heavy.
Yep, in the wind. And so I think I spent the rest of the time just eating the snacks in the player lounge.
Is that a fat joke?
It was a good time.
Strike two.
So there's your golf story.
Love it. Mike's stories come with visual aids, typically. Oh, that one's going to miss the cars, unfortunately. Is it going to make it to the road? Yes, it does. And across. And in the ditch.
I think a rattlesnake would take that.
Yep, the rattlesnake might have popped in the head. A little cold out for a rattlesnake today. Count remains 0-2.
They're just moving slow.
Yep. Another one right over us and hit a nice tree and stopped. Oh, that stopped it.
Actually, I took my beautiful daughter Addie to the rattlesnake roundup 2 weeks ago.
And?
In Sweetwater. She loved it. Got to touch a live rattlesnake.
No, thank you.
She's tough. Got to eat one.
Tastes like chicken, I hear.
Yes.
Oh, here's a foul that might have a chance. It hits the windshield of the Trinity Christian bus.
Oh, Ellison is not going to be happy about that.
We'll see if anybody goes to check on it. It hits dead center, it looked like, of the Trinity Christian bus windshield.
Did not bust it.
Oh, he's inside the bus, too. Brad is sitting in the driver's seat. Excuse me, Coach Ellison.
Probably spilt his coffee all over his
back. He had actually mentioned taking a nap earlier. I wonder if he was asleep. Swing and a miss. Andy Kincaid gets out of this inning as well. How many pitches did it take this time, Coach Riley?
He's at 59 pitches. A little less consistent
man.
There. Had 10 pitches on an inning.
10-pitch inning, so, which you will take every time.
A little disappointed in him.
And as
we were really going for 4.
Yeah.
He went with 10.
Yeah, we'd like to see a 3-pitch inning, wouldn't we?
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
But we'll forgive him.
Indeed, man. So, what'd you say he's got? 59 now?
59.
Through 5, 59 pitches. I bet Andy finishes the entire game. Great job by Andrew Kincaid. Going to the top of the 6th. Trinity Christian still up 4-0 on the 4 runs they scored in the top of the 2nd.
New pitcher coming to the mound.
Ooh.
Number 35. Kay West. He was at third base. Now we have...
Other guy was actually doing pretty good. I'm surprised they took him out. Oh, okay. There's one at the backstop, almost killing Coach Hicks.
Looks like the pitcher just took third base, so they just flip-flop.
That's the easy change. Here's Rhett making his third or fourth round. Looks like Caden's going to throw some. Caden's gonna warm up with your boy.
How come?
Oh, they gave you your money back? Awesome.
DoorDash.
Ah.
Well, the whole thing is just like.
Just ours. Not yours.
And I pay for mine or just
yours? I
pay for it. I got it free.
I don't know what's going
Turns
on.
Turns out that Kyle Muchagumba is not the only mooch that we have here.
Oh, wow.
My elderly father is also mooching off of us with his Starbucks order.
Isn't that his prerogative at this point in your life?
Apparently he did not have his checkbook to write a check for the coffee.
Again, here we are at the top of the sixth. Trinity Christian up 4-0. If you missed it before this game, JV was able to defeat Midland Classical 6-3, coming from, they weren't behind, they were tied. No, they were behind 3-2.
They were down 2-0 and then 3-2.
Yeah, and they came back scoring four, I believe, in the fifth, I think it was. Yeah, it was. And in that game, if you go back and watch it, I dare you to time how long it takes Cooper Neesmith to get from home to second. Might have time to cook a whole meal.
That is so wrong.
I love Cooper Neesmith with all my heart, but he is a slow dude.
Good thing he can hit.
Yes, and do a little bit of pitching here and there too.
Oh, absolutely, great curveball.
Yeah,
filthy. Cooper Young coming to the plate.
Cooper with that gun of an arm. He plays all over the place too.
He does.
I've seen him play some third and play it well, too.
Plays third, plays in the outfield, can play short second. Has even played a little bit of first and even caught a little bit during tournament season.
Oh, we can take those versatile guys.
No doubt.
What is JV all packed up to do here? Anticipating six runs and calling it?
I like it. I like their confidence.
Yes.
Unfortunately, they're blocking the view for the rest of the fans.
Good thing my camera's high enough and not blocking anything for me. Oh,
incorrect.
Looked a little high and outside, personally.
I do like the elevated bleachers here at Midland Classic.
Yeah, it's kind of nice being high.
The view is nice. The wind is not.
Mm-bop. Sorry, I had that backwards there. There you go.
Got the turf area for the fans to sit in their lawn chairs around.
That seems to be their favorite thing to do, is it is packed down there on the turf.
There's
Cooper hit that one into the gap, and that one's going to roll for a while. One of the deepest areas in this entire park. Coop's already around second before they even touch the ball. He's got at least a stand-up triple, and that's where they're going to stop him. Coach Rocha holds him up at third. Great way to start this sixth inning. Cooper Young, stand-up triple to right at that scoreboard.
Great swing, great place. That's exactly where you want to hit it in this ballpark.
No lie.
Deep. Their center fielder is really kind of shading a little bit towards left.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of room to run if you can be disciplined and hit the right center like Cooper did just there.
And I walked the outfield with Coach Fowler before the JV game, and it is scalped. I mean, it's down to nothing. That ball will roll and roll and roll.
Yeah. We were talking earlier. We don't think they put down winter rye, which is the typical overseeding of baseball fields. You have a Bermuda mix with a winter rye. And we don't think they put down any winter rye because it is very brown.
Yeah.
And you're just starting to see a little bit of the Bermuda come out, which means it is going to be fast.
Wow.
On that grass right now.
A little bit of Coach Hiley's nerd side there. Another base hit to left field. That'll score that run. Cooper Young coming in to score. Trinity up 5-0. On that base hit by Noah Hasse, it brings up pitcher Andrew Kincaid. Still no outs here in the top of the sixth. I can't wait to hear Coach Ellison's story. I'm dying to know if he was asleep on that one.
Andrew squaring to bunt again. This is going to be a banner day with multiple bunts by Andrew Kincaid.
Not sure that's exactly what Coach Rocha wanted him to do.
Seems to be a change in game plan here. Andrew, hit the ball hard to right center field. Run all day.
I'm betting we had a hit and run here. Nope. Squaring up to bunt.
We might have a fake bunt slash here, actually.
Ooh, I love fake bunt slashes.
Third baseman's way in. Second baseman's a little short, too. No?
Nope.
We are just pulling away and letting them steal.
And we'll take that base as the ball gets past the catcher.
I think Coach Rocha saw something there that their catcher was doing and wanted to keep him back a little bit.
And how is Coach Rocha so smart? I think it's his Texas history teacher he had back in seventh grade.
Don't know about that.
Yeah, that's got to be what it is. Or his football coach when he was an eighth grader as well. I wonder who that was. Oh, that was me. I forgot.
I am pretty confident that's not where it came from.
It can't be what it is. There's a strike to Andrew Kincaid after that ball earlier that I forgot to put on the live stream. That is a ball outside, at least that's what it looks like.
2-1 count.
2-1, no outs, one in. And on second.
Rocha reminding the dugout to stay in the game, stay locked in. Especially first game of a district.
Yeah, district foe.
You definitely don't want to lose focus. You don't want to give them any momentum going into Saturday.
Indeed.
I'm going to go ahead and put them down here and do it in convincing fashion.
Yeah, let's do that.
Go ahead and send Midland Classical out of our district with two losses as we move up to 5A.
Yeah, we only see them one more time and then we won't see them again.
We will be back in Midland with another district foe, however, next year. The old Mustangs from Midland Christian.
Don't they play in that semi-pro park over there?
They do.
That's going to be a fun one right there.
Christensen Field, yep.
Christensen, whoop. Well, I think he hit both the ball and the catcher's mitt, and that is catcher's interference.
Again, I think that's probably what Coach Rocha was seeing earlier, the catcher kind of working his way forward.
I believe that is the second time that's happened, the first time the umpires have actually noticed it. I think it happened in the JV game. Coach Fowler was trying to call it.
We have a pinch hitter here.
Oh, we got Colt Condren coming in.
Colt Condren hitting for Brant Lecker. Colt was actually the one that had the interference. No, it was Slade Reed. I apologize.
Yeah, that's right. It was Slade. Two on, no outs.
And we have a box.
They just boxed, so we move over 90 more feet. Oh my goodness. Another run in for the Lions. Noah Hasse scoring on that wild pitch.
I'm going to call that one a pass ball, actually.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Did he not have to lunge to his right for that?
He did not have to lunge. He did reach slightly, but it was off the net. And he did not lunge, so I'm going to call that one a pass.
That's one thing I am not good at knowing the difference on that one, because someone in the past told me everything like that is a wild pitch.
I might be a little more critical on catchers than some.
Okay. That's actually good. I need to learn something today. Woo! I think Colt wanted that one, but held up. 2-0. Never saw it.
Straight up
to the first baseman or second baseman.
Right fielder also did not see it. First baseman was able to make the play, however.
First out of the inning, Colt Condren pops out to the first baseman. Brings up Carson Castillo. Come on, freshman. Bring that run in. Andrew Kincaid gets his lead over there on third. Carson showing bunt.
Pulls it back, and a wild pitch scores Andrew from third. Anywho. Number of errors that have happened here, not true errors, but mess-ups, have led to three runs here in the top of the sixth.
Carson is 1-for-2, going to the shortstop both times. Hit over his head and a ground out.
Guess you can still play the shift in this level, can't you?
You could. It would be dumb, but
yes.
You could.
Yes. Oh, really?
There we go again. You don't need to shift when he just hits everything to the shortstop.
Directly to
play the shortstop.
The shortstop. All three balls hit by Carson to the shortstop. Top of the order for the Lions, J.J. Martinez. I believe this is fourth at bat. It is. With a hit to, what is that? A hit to...
Two hits to center and one ground out.
Two hits to center and a ground out to second.
2-3 on the day. We'll take another one to right center.
Good day for J.J.
Keep harping on that, but look at the space out there.
Yeah, the center fielder is in short left center. What is going on? The center fielder's in short left center. I don't know if I said that right.
The right fielder's playing straight up, so that gap is huge.
Oh, yeah, you hit it straight to the Pro Petro sign, and that's an inside the parker right there. We've lost a few. We're down to 17 live streamers. Ooh, that looked like a swipe bat. We're getting to put the count on the board. 2-1. Actually, he says 1-2. What do you got?
It is 1-2.
Oh. The 11-year-old has been wrong over there on the scoreboard quite a few times. And the Lions are down after scoring 3 here in the top of the 6th. Going to the bottom of the 6th. Trinity Christian up on Midland Classical 7-0. I was going to say, what's wrong with Johnny B. Good? Coach Holly taking a big old swig of his cold Starbucks drink that was supposed to be hot. And the Johnny B. Good song is skipping.
Johnny is not being good.
Nope. Please skip over to little Leonard Skinner. Turn it up.
Turn it up, Leonard. Colt Cochran stays in the game in right field.
Yep. Your boy coming out to warm up, Andrew.
Rex doing a little more warm-up duty. Big day on Thursday, going to get his final release off of his elbow surgery.
Nice.
Pretty excited.
I bet. One of the, changing sports real fast, one of the top 10 linebackers in his class in the entire state.
He came in at number 10, I believe.
Number 10, his brother was what?
Number 4.
The Hileys are
highly respected as linebackers. His brother let him know about it.
See that play on words there?
Yeah, I like it. Turns out our family bracket this year for March Madness is aptly named Highly Intelligent. Unfortunately, if you look at our brackets, you would disagree.
Yeah, because it was highly improbable that you were going to win. So
all of us are not doing so great.
Well, being that basketball is boring, so.
Ooh, hot taste.
Yeah. I love Trinity Christian basketball. That's all I do.
We are big fans of March Madness and of Texas Tech basketball in our household.
I agree with that. I would love to see Coach McCaslin be monstrously successful.
Did a great job this year.
Yep.
Coming in late. He's fun to watch, Coach. For sure.
I've been out of it for so long, I hadn't watched much. I need to get back into it with his kiddos going to Trinity. That's really cool.
Yeah, he seems to coach them the right way, which is fun to watch.
Awesome. Really enjoyed watching Jet play this year. Little sniper that he is. Here we go. Andrew, his 60th pitch of the day, and we got a bunt. Andrew throws him out. One pitch, one out. Hey, we're on track for that three pitch inning.
Let's do it. You know, my favorite thing about watching Jet play basketball is actually his defense.
Oh, he is an animal.
He's an animal, and he is so fun to watch defensively. A little scary, because sometimes he flies around a little bit.
Yeah. Like you were saying about Noah being super smart in his sport, I think Jet's like that with basketball. He just knows.
Super savvy.
Yeah, super smart. Oh, I should put that on the board.
As are all coaches' kids.
Yeah. Really, that was a selfless plug right there, or self-ish plug.
I'm just saying.
And that'll be a base hit right there.
Into the place we don't want him to hit it. Luckily, Carson
cut that off nice.
Cuts it off well.
That one was right at the Pro Petro, like we were saying a minute ago.
Carson covered a lot of ground there.
Mm-hmm.
You got Colton in right with a lot of speed too, so.
Good defense, job, freshman.
Definitely. Yep. Defense definitely played that ball well. Levi Bailey coming to play. He's 0-for-2 today. 3-hole from Midland Classical.
So the meat of their order here. Strike.
Little random fact for you. I have actually taken Levi on a mission trip to Costa Rica with his family.
Oh, really?
Yeah, his sister went on a volleyball mission trip with me, and he came as well.
See if this is two. Nope, not gonna be two, and not gonna be one. Yikes. There's an E6 there. Two on with one out.
Another ball that Mooch probably set back on a little too much. I know the grass is cut a little funny here. And
would you charge that?
Not the easiest place to play shortstop, I would assume.
That it's so.
Mooch would typically charge that ball.
Mm-hmm.
But this field is.
The dirt is so tough.
It's cut right in from where it normally is. It's a good 3 to 4 foot cut further in than normal.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
So. Your normal hop comes off a little bit different here.
Yep.
Another
chance to
here.
Is redeem himself.
Only plays at first.
Got him.
A great play.
Good job, Mooch. Good job, Mooch.
Great play, great throw.
I feel good.
Really, the only play he had could have gone to third there, but I don't think.
I don't know he would have gotten him.
Don't think he would have got him. Mooch never hesitated and jumped and made a rocket throw over to Caden.
Definitely
well done.
Got an arm. Yep. Two outs, man, on second and third. What, the 4-hole hitter or the 5-hole hitter?
This is the 5-hole.
Five. That is
over his head.
That's gonna score two, folks. Stand up double for the 5-hole hitter. And the Knights are on the board here in the bottom of the sixth.
Colt unfortunately didn't quite play that one right. Wind's still moving a little bit up high, especially, and he came in a step before he went back. And would have been a hard play anyway, but I think his speed, I think he normally makes that play.
Yeah, they cut it too.
Just played
tight.
It a little short, yeah.
Yep.
The good thing about a 7-2 lead, though, is you can recover real quickly here, get this quick out, and
one inning left.
Get back in the dugout.
Yep. Swing and a miss.
Andrew making him look silly there.
I believe those two runs are unearned, too, yes?
I don't know.
E6.
Yeah, there was an E6, so you are correct.
Yeah. So those two runs will not go against Mr. Kincaid there.
We have had at least three seasons here at the ballpark today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It was summer and then winter and then spring.
Have a nice spring day now here.
Yep. The calmest it's been all day right here, right now. strike. You got 2-2?
I do. The JV comes rolling back in with the pieces.
Ah. Raise my hand to you.
Coach Fowler tells them they can't eat yet, and Cooper Neesmith looks incredibly disappointed as he receives that news from Coach.
Staying alive, staying alive.
Coach Fowler. Kyle Kettner expresses extreme dislike in that decision as well.
Yeah, JV is just down there salivating.
The fact that he ran all the way over here for nothing, still yep. wearing his cleats from the game.
Yeah, no, you're asking, why did you not straighten that camera out like a long time ago before? It's a little bit straighter than it's been for the last four innings.
We'll blame the wind.
Yeah, we'll blame the wind. That's the easiest thing to do. That's skied up to Carson. That should be a can of corn.
A can of corn there for Mr.
And there it is. Two runs in the inning for Midland Classical. 7-2 going top of the seventh. Game's only 2 hours old. It's not too bad.
Interested to see if we see another pinch hitter or two in this top
yeah.
of the seven. We do have.
What order are we in?
We're 2-3-4.
I doubt you.
I would not pinch hit for either
guys.
Of those cats.
Yep. Got the big time meat of the order coming up for the Lions. Really hoping to have a HR over the right field fence, but. Last opportunity. I think he wants to know. It's the anti-COVID song.
Hey!
Hicks 73
59 of those are strikes. It got
That's
caught
awesome.
Me off a little bit.
That's awesome. So you think they let him start the seventh and just see how it goes?
You know, I definitely think that he probably goes out unless they're just looking to get
somebody some work.
Get Caden a little loose.
I think he did go over and warm up, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. And he threw a great game last weekend.
Yeah, he did.
And so I would not be shocked to see Caden out in the seventh.
Indeed.
But Andrew definitely has enough in the tank to finish if they want to. It's just
yep.
what they want to do. That's yep. some of the joys of our pitching staff. Levi Bailey from center field.
Walked on four pitches last time.
Yeah, we've got a little more velocity on the left. I'm seeing Hunter almost the left side of the gap.
Okay. Definitely staying. Wow, he gets strike on that one. Staying down on him, at least away.
I'm going to make my call.
Okay.
Hunter left side of the gap double.
Okay. Good in the field today, too.
but we're excited to have it for at least another year.
Yeah, we're glad he's not a senior.
I mean, the rest of this
gonna,
year.
Is he going to redshirt or something? Yeah.
We're not having any super seniors.
Yeah. Yeah, most people don't, like, volunteer to do another year in high school.
Yeah, if they'd let me fail him in senior Bible and get another year of eligibility, I would, but... Turns out that's not the way that works.
Nope, that's not the way that works. Uh-oh, the wind is kicking up again. After I was just thinking it was calming down.
And Levi, I'm very disappointed after taking you on this trip that you don't allow me to get my call.
Oh, are we getting some sprinkles here?
Yes.
Sprinkles? We're getting sprinkles.
While it's sunny.
Yeah, that's strange. Hey, I kind of need the rain to not rain on my gear.
We have an ask Rory Suarez for a piece of pizza, which he promptly denies.
Oh no, what is going on here? This is not good. My gear. It's like sunny and it's raining. I can't get this stinking little bitty umbrella that I have out to protect my stuff.
Oh, just misses
and
out.
Apparently I
fouls it back.
Okay, folks, I may have to stop doing balls and strikes. I'm just going to leave it at zeros for the moment. There is stuff
Mooch
falling from the sky.
Mooch, as he tries to call timeout, the umpire doesn't give it to him. And he has to swing and lines out to the shortstop.
Unbelievable.
While he was actually out of the batter's box already, and the umpire doesn't give him time.
That's ridiculous.
It's fascinating.
Yes. This weather is slightly insane. We were just saying it was nice. Where is this rain coming from?
We were looking for that fourth season, and yeah. We now have a little fall... A little fall shower.
A little rainbow in right center now, right over the scoreboard. I don't know if you can see it on the live stream. Oh, is right.
He's caught up. He is in a rundown. Oh, no. He is not interested in making another.
Yep. It's crazy. The rain is coming from the direction where there's nothing but blue sky. That makes no sense. I think it's finally calming down now. Wow, I think this umbrella has had it. Actually, a full rainbow here in Midland.
And sunshine where the rain's coming from.
Yeah, and sun, and now the umbrella is stuck on stuff. There we go. Strike. Done with that now? That was insane.
Looks like we're done with the short little rain shower.
We've had everything today. Foul that hits the street, looks like. Wow, this umbrella has had it. I think I need to throw this away.
Yeah, that umbrella's probably not going to make it out of Midland.
I'm gonna keep it till we get out of here, though, in case it rains again.
I don't think it'll matter with that umbrella.
Yeah. And Coop's gonna make it to first.
No!
No way! No way!
Ooh,
as we have the worst call of the day.
Well, he was only 90 foot away. He can see it fine.
Okay, after that little bit of fiasco with the weather, we're going to the bottom of the seventh. Trinity up 7-2, only need 3 outs, and we're done for the day. What numbers are coming up there, boss?
We have 7-8-9, bomb and run.
7-8-9, I will take the 7-8-9. I see Coach Ellison has retreated to the safe confines of the baseball beaten bus.
Well, the JV took the pizza there, so.
Oh, that would make sense. Well, there's some JV in front of us.
He currently has a pizza box in his hand in the bus.
Do you want me to steal a pizza box from a Rory Suarez here below me?
You want one?
No, you're good, bro.
We're going to let Rory put on all the meat that he can.
Yeah, Rory needs to eat, put on some weight.
In fact, we're going to go get him another pizza.
And a hamburger and whatever else we can stuff in him. Wow, that was weird. Now the sun's back out and it's warm and the wind's not blowing anymore. Ah, West Texas. Banan. Little Diddy. Oh, how are we looking on time? 6:33. Nice throw.
Andrew back out to finish here.
Awesome.
Gets another chance at his 3-pitch inning.
Hopefully can. What, 5's is best?
5's is best so far. We would settle for 4.
Yep. Still got almost a full rainbow. Very pronounced on the right side, y'all can't see. A little bit of one coming down over the Pro Petro and the gym in the distance, but almost can't see it at all now. Well, now it smells clean out here.
It smells great. That's not a saying I get to say very often in Midland.
It smells clean in Midland. Oh, first time for everything. And a bouncer to Andrew. 1 pitch and 1 out. All right, that's 1. We need 2 more. Going for that 3-pitch inning. Now the sun feels good. Oh. 2 pitches, 2 outs. Oh, we got a chance, folks, for that 3-pitch inning. Andrew Kincaid, 2 outs on 2 pitches.
What could you possibly be arguing about? Oh, we've got a pinch hitter.
We've got a what?
Pinch hitter.
Oh, okay.
Number 33, Jay Dunn. Hitting in the 9 hole. Need him to swing at the first pitch.
And he did not. Doesn't. And there goes the 3-pitch inning.
But I did technically say that I was looking for a 4-pitch, and so
okay.
Andrew all is right. Very obedient.
We'll give it to Coach Charlie this time.
And we'll appreciate it if he gets a job done here.
Nope.
Andrew, I'm extremely disappointed in you.
Charlie has very high standards. And the grounder to short. Mooch backhands it, and what are you going to say on that one, boss?
You know, I hate to do it.
It hit the ground first.
But I was a first baseman, and I think that hop has to be played correctly. I'm going to give that error to first baseman Caden Castillo.
Yes, sir. What was that, third error today? Is that
it's,
right?
It's a hard call.
I thought it was a hit.
Kyle disagrees. He wants a hit. Interesting.
Nah, if he had played that carom, he'd been out. So that can't be a hit. It's just who do you give the error to?
So I don't think necessarily ever throw the hits to ground.
Yeah.
Qualifies as an error. So
okay. He's usually really good picking those off the ground.
I'm going to say that I'm going to say that Caden would have expected to get that.
Yep. Okay.
Every pitch from here on out, I'm dropping Andrew's Bible grade by a point. So we're going to hope that he gets it right here.
Oh, that's good.
He currently has 100 in my class.
Okay. So he has a few points to give. And there's a grounder.
We're going to keep that 100, Andrew.
And there's
well
your
done.
Fielder's choice ending the game. Trinity Christian defeats Midland Classical here from Midland on the grounds of Midland Classical Academy, which is a really cool campus, by the way. By the score of 7-2 here in game one. Game two will be on Saturday. Great pitching performance by Andrew Kincaid. Trinity Christian goes to 6-1 on district, in district, excuse me. And Midland Classical drops to 2-1. Again, these two teams will meet on Saturday from Lions Park, starting at, you said noon, right?
Noon.
At noon. So come out and watch them play, and we will see you then. So for Ford and for my color man, Ryan Hiley, sitting to my right, we will sign off and see you next time. So for Trinity Christian Sports and YouTube, see you later.